Hey everyone, welcome to another volume of my layered armor sets that I've made in Monster Hunter Rise. If this is your first time watching, in these videos I show 7 layered armor sets that I've made using different pieces of armor in the game. And yeah, let's get started in a moment. But first, this is the Origin layered armor set. This was actually just added recently, and actually it was released after I made the last video, so obviously I didn't have time to put anything using pieces from this in that video. But I made a couple in this video, and I'm going to show them here. But yeah, the Origin layered armor set, this recently appeared in Monster Hunter World Iceborne as well, and it's actually from the original Monster Hunter game, so that's pretty cool. But yeah, let's get started. The first layered armor I'm going to show in this video is the Desert Rust armor. When I was making this layered armor, I wanted to use Origin pieces, and the helm in particular of the Origin armor reminded me of like something in the desert, so I wanted to make something kind of deserty. I definitely wanted to use the Kushala chest because I don't think I've used it in a prior video yet, and I just tried to make everything match. Okay, so here are the pieces: Origin helm, Kushala cista, alloy van braces, Origin coil, and ingot greaves. Alright, pigments. For the head, Pigment 1 is going to be 000, and Pigment 2 is going to be 1540-70. The chest, Pigment 1, is 1558-76, and then Pigment 2 is going to be 315-1421. Alright, for the arms, you're going to go to Change All, 1465-15. Pigment 1 on the waist is going to be 1415-10. And Pigment 2 is going to be 1571-45. Alright, and then for the legs, make that 1545-10. And that's it. Okay, the second layered armor I'm going to show in this video is the Climber armor. For this one, I mixed and matched different pieces. I definitely wanted to use the Origin coil, and then I put on the Lodroth mail, and I thought that looked pretty cool, and then I, you know, try to make everything match. So here are the pieces: Lodroth helm, Lodroth mail, Hunter's van braces, Origin coil, and Hunter's greaves. Alright, for the head and chest, pigments 1 and 2 are going to be exactly the same. So pigment 1 on both is going to be 1675-20. And then Pigment 2 is going to be 30-65-45. Alright, for the arms, you're going to use 1680-5. Then Pigment 2 is going to be 30-65-40. Alright, for the waist, you're going to use 0050 for Pigment 1. And then Pigment 2 is going to be the default color. And then finally, the legs, you're going to use 1675-10 for Pigment 1. Then Pigment 2 is going to be 30-65-45. Alright, and that's it. Alright, for those of you that are playing Pokemon Legends right now, you might recognize this one. This is the Adamant layered armor. So yeah, Adamant is a major character in Pokemon Legends. And he's pretty cool. I like his character. But yeah, when I was playing the game, this is how I know I'm making too many layered armors. When I was playing the game, when he first appeared, I'm like, I could probably make a layered armor based on him in Monster Hunter, because like his clothing reminded me of some pieces in the game. But anyway, here we go. the parts that you're going to use: Azure Age Hair, Lodroth Mail, Shell-Studded Gloves, Lodroth Coil, and Sonic Shoes. You can also use the Nargacuga Braces for the arms instead if you want. I thought the Shell-Studded Gloves look a little bit better. Alright, Pigments. For the head, Pigment 1 is going to be 0050, and Pigment 2 is going to be 242-95-10. For the chest, Pigment 1 is going to be 230-150, and Pigment 2 is going to be 0050. For the arms, both colors are going to be 0050. The waist is going to be 230-150 for Pigment 1, and then Pigment 2 is going to be 0050. And then for the legs, go to Change All, and you're going to change both colors to 000. And there it is. I think I got as close as I could get. Okay, the fourth armor I'm going to show in this video is the Nightmare layered armor. For this armor, I definitely wanted to use the diver's mask with like an actual armor. And, you know, I kind of envisioned this as like, you know, an armor set from like a dystopian future type thing. I don't know. I just had like some scenario in my head, and that's what led me to make this one. Okay, so the pieces you're going to use: diver's mask, Almadron mail, Damascus fan braces, Damascus coil, and ingot greaves. Alright, for the pigments, pigment 1 on the head is going to be 35-65-75, then pigment 2 is going to be 000. For the chest, pigment 1 is going to be 000, and then pigment 2 is going to be 40-75-35. Pigment 1 on the arms is going to be 40-65-20, and then pigment 2 is going to be 000. For the waist, go to change all, both pigments are going to be 000. And then for the legs, pigment 1 is also going to be 000. And pigment 2 is going to be 35-65-75. Okay, and that's the Nightmare layered armor. Here's the next layered armor in this video. This is the Outlaw layered armor. Okay, those of you that have been watching the Monster Hunter Rise uploads on my channel probably remember this one from a long time ago. I accidentally deleted the layered armor loadout for this one, and I was watching a video because I was working on a compilation, and I was like, oh, I forgot about that one, so I just remade it again recently. So here are the parts for it: Bone Helm, Roggy Mail, Roggy Van Braces, Roggy Coil, and Black Leather Legs. Alright, pigments. Pigment 1 on the head is going to be 0074. Then pigment 2 is going to be 000. Alright, the chest, arms, and waist are all going to stay the same. Just keep them the default colors. And then for the legs, pigment 1 is going to be 000. Pigment 2 is going to be the default color. Pretty simple armor set. I like how it looks, especially with like the skull and the kind of cowboy look. Okay, here's the second last armor set I'm featuring in this video. This is the Red Mage layered armor. Okay, so in case you missed the last video, I would check that out. But I did make a layered armor set based on Heian from Final Fantasy XIV. I'm not a player of the game, but Kevin and Kyle played it or have played it. I was looking at different classes from the game. When I searched it, the Red Mage came up. I'm like, you know what? I could definitely make an armor set based on that. So this is based on the Red Mage outfit from Final Fantasy XIV. All right, so the pieces, you're going to use Brigade Lobos, Brigade Suit, Orion Vambraces, Brigade Coil, and Swallow Boots. Unfortunately, the Swallow Boots are a paid DLC costume piece. All right, for the colors, for the head, chest, arms, and waist, you're going to use the same colors for Pigment 1 and 2. So Pigment 1 on all of them is going to be 09429, and then Pigment 2 is going to be 000. All right, but for the legs, you're going to use 09090 for Pigment 1, and the Pigment 2 is going to be 000. So yeah, like I said, pretty easy to make. I think it looks pretty accurate, or at least as close as I could get it. Okay, here's the last layered armor set I'm featuring in this video. This is the Quest Ender layered armor. All right, those of you that have played Monster Hunter Generations Ultimate probably recognize this outfit. The Quest Ender in that game gave you the quest, and we were talking about him recently in one of the Monster Hunter Rise streams that we were doing. And when I pulled up this picture, because I couldn't exactly remember what he looked like, I was like, "Yeah, I think I could make that too." So again, that's how you know you're making a lot of layered armor sets. You just look at something and you want to make that into a layered armor set in the game. All right, but here are the pieces for it. You're going to use the Shadow Shades, Brigade Suit, Brigade Vambraces, Leather Belts, and Leather Pants. All right, pigments. So Pigment 1 for the head, you're going to use 005, and then Pigment 2 is going to be 525090. For the chest and arms, you're going to actually use the same colors for both. Pigment 1 on both is going to be 127010, then Pigment 2 is going to be the default color. For the waist, you're going to use 169015 for Pigment 1, and then Pigment 2 is going to be 157913. And then for the legs, go to change all, use 120450. And there you go. That is the Quest Ender layered armor. As always, when I try to make layered armors based on things from other games, I try to get it as accurate as I can, you know, based on what they give me in the game. And, you know, I think it looks fairly accurate. Okay, and there you have it. There's seven more layered armor sets that I made in this game. As always, I still have more that I haven't shown yet. As they add more layered armor set pieces in the game, I make more, but as you've seen here, I've made more pieces just based on older ones that I haven't messed around with yet. You know, the possibilities are endless. But yeah, if you enjoyed the video, leave a like and a comment. Again, I pretty much say it at the end of every video, but I really enjoy making these, so, you know, that's more content for me to make and for you to enjoy if you do enjoy these. But yeah, as always, thank you for watching. Hey, thanks for checking out today's video. I want to give a special thanks to all of my supporters on YouTube, Twitch, and Discord. And shout out to Silverwind, StunnerX001, CaptainCactus45, Jin Manning, T-Shirt Printer, and Scrub for being elite channel members. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and you can check out my social media links in the video description. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.